have a musical selection by Mr. Wayne Prestige, and he will be accompanied by Mr. B. Price.
How's it going, Mount Canaan? It's Christmas time. Right. I'm going to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
hope that everyone has enjoyed the program tonight. And we are now going to be featured by the remarks from our pastor. But just for the pastor, come. I didn't see where I am, but I'm lying in the wind. So.
Baby want to sing some more.
Well, that's a good sound, isn't it? We need some babies around this place. I think I know that one. Yeah, I do. She hasn't been coming much. She's been coming more next year.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, y'all look so good out there.
Well,
some of y'all look better than others, but y'all really look good out there. Thank you for coming, as already has been said. It's a wonderful thing on the 24th of December. And I hope that some of you are Sister Maddie Williams, you might be able to do it as a barometer, because I know the first one that we did, I know your daughter Tawny was still at home, and she was a part of it. I hope that y'all can go back and kind of come up with a number. I know we're getting near 30 years, if not at 30, and it was so simple. It was so simple. And I want us to always remember Mrs. Sophie Johnson, who's going on to be with the Lord now. But she said, we just need to do something on Christmas Eve night. And she just kept reminding us until we just decided just to go and do it. And some of these semi-senior citizens, right, Tyler? Y'all would be senior citizens in the next few years. They were very young. And we found out that we had so much talent in this church that it absolutely blew our minds, including Chester Jennings and all that, Lisa Butler, and all of those names of our senior citizens. Now, I just get in, I say, anyway. So about 30 years ago, we just decided to start doing it. And we have been doing it. And it gets better and better. It's more creative. You never know what you're going to get from one year to another. We've brought in professional musicians. We've done it all ourselves. We've had a mixture of it. We've had skits and that to take priority. So it's just a night that we at Mount Canaan has given, we have given ourselves as a Christmas gift. And I have the dubious privilege today, the first time that I have ever been to a funeral on Christmas Eve. And it kind of dampens your Santa Claus, you know what I'm saying? So I really needed this tonight. I really did. And a classmate of mine passed away on yesterday. Daryl, what's his name? Butler? Blocker, Daryl Blocker. The minister, Reverend Daryl Blocker. Mother, Dorothy Sinkins, when we went to school. She's Dorothy Butler now. But, and then a young lady in Aiken turned out to be from Johnston, and the family knew me, you know. So I had a lot on me. And one of my deacons came and asked me, well, really, I think he had some ibuprofen in his hands, and he wanted to give me something to pick me up. He said, you look so bad. So when we look out across, your face just jumps out. I told him, I said, no, I needed a pick-me-up tonight. So I want to thank you. Because you had so much energy. And the whiter the hair was, the more energy that came. So we really enjoyed ourselves tonight. I want to recognize all of you, but I do want to thank some people who are here for the first time, and some of them a long ways from home. Sister Betty Scott, a dear friend of mine. Amen.
Amen.
And that her home church just made us a gift of an organ as we go into our new building. Haiti Baptist Church had one more organ than they needed, and they gave it to us. And I don't want to say it too loud, but I believe they gave us the best one. Amen. They didn't want to give us anything that they didn't want. So we are so thankful to Haiti Baptist Church. And as soon as we get our carpet in and a few other things, we will be borrowing somebody's pickup truck, probably yours, Bob. We go over there and pick up that wonderful organ. And we want to welcome you tonight because I think this is the first one that you attend. And I see some folks here from St. Louis. Are y'all from St. Louis? Y'all look strange. Y'all not out of gas, right? Somebody said there was some folks back there from St. Louis. That's y'all from St. Louis. Amen. Stand up so the church can see how St. Louis folks look. Y'all know how hard it is for me to say from St. Louis. I was talking to my nephew in St. Louis this evening. We were talking about y'all. Amen. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you got a good job, but I sure wish I could see you every Sunday morning. Amen. Maybe one day, huh? Maybe one day. My cousin and growing up friend, who was quite a saxophone player himself in school, and that was our brother Johnny Willie Bright, who has moved back here from Washington State, and we're very happy to have him tonight. This is his place. And his wife, to spend time with us. Anthony, you didn't give me a
last name. What's his last name?
Who? Anthony Tovar and his wife Joy and daughter. Mona Lisa.
Amen. Oh, LA, I thought it was Pepperdine. But anyway, Los Angeles, California. Let's give them. These are the offsprings of our saxophone player, Brother Preston. Thank you very much. Amen. And the rest of the persons who are not members of Mount Canaan that my mind will not allow me to call your name right now, would you please stand and get me off the hook, please? All non-Mount Canaan members who are visiting with us tonight, please stand so that Mount Canaan can welcome you. Let's give them a Mount Canaan. Should I have opened the doors of the church? Who has a wife and sisters? Brother Brown, there's somebody that will actually put up with this gentleman. with all his playing guitars and stuff around the house. Y'all stand, amen. God bless you. Let's give them a round of applause. Amen. 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 Y'all see them so much still. Amen. They're not strangers. Amen. They're part of the Venice Brandonville ethos. Amen. Amen. Is Santa Claus on here today? Did he stop by?
He ran out of
bread. No, they had to put the chocolate Santa Claus in the hospital New Orleans. Yeah, they had to put him in the hospital. So do we have a chocolate Santa Claus? Got nothing against y'all white folks, but we want chocolate. We want chocolate. We have a lot of fun in my head. If you got thin skin, then you need to tell me so that I can look in another direction when I rip you up a little bit. Amen. It's in the gym. Well, we have some fruit and stuff in the gym. Okay, so we're going to ask you when you leave here to go over to the gym. See, does he have a poem with him? We forgive him because his wife hasn't been feeling very good. He's been trying to be a nurse. I'm a deacon.
Oh, you got a point. Yeah.
Okay, so you didn't bring a poem with you tonight? All right, well, come on down here and get this one out of your head.
Yeah.
Boy, you know, we. We are blessed at Mount Canaan when you can call on somebody to be a poet. Now, people are always calling on you to pray or read the scripture, but when you can call on somebody to just give us some poetic whatever you got there, brother, let's give a family for God.
Searching for myself, trying to find myself, trying to get in where I fit in, you know. This is the way that I deal with problems in life and trouble and pain. This is a trash or neutral, abstract poem called Neutral. You know, the reason why I wrote the poem because, you know, if you look at a window pane, your vision travels straight through the pane. It don't stop on the inside of the pane, you know. And poetry has a lot of facets to It's transforming, it's thought provoking, and it's written emotions, you know. And that's the way I deal with pain, you know. I let the pain, I transform myself into being something transparent. So when pain or problems hit me in life, it travels through me. It don't stay inside of me. And the title of this poem is neutral. I'm a color without a color. I have a heart without a care. I'm a person without a purpose. I'm not going anywhere. I blend with colors many, but only compatible to a few. A true friend, I don't have any. Well, maybe one or two. But if you're wondering why I'm neutral, I think I don't make any sense. Well, I find that being neutral is my only self-defense. But I am beauty, hidden beauty. I'm really something to behold. I'm a child in a man's body, growing young instead of old. I'm a diamond in the rough. I'm not cheap, simulated glass. I have a mind with a memory of my horrid childhood past. I'm a book without a story. I'm an actor without a play. Maybe between here and glory, I might find myself.
Wow.
And a poem, another poem I like, is a poem about spiritual freedom that I wrote. I was inspired to write this poem when my wife, Betty, went to a pet shop on her birthday and bought a cockatiel parrot. And when she came home with the parrot, she had it in a cage. And when I looked at the bird, it reminded me of a person in jail or a person in spiritual bondage before they find the law. It's called a cockatiel in a cage. This is our friend, it is our pet, but it hasn't found true freedom yet. But Betty keeps it locked inside a cage. Sometimes it rants and sometimes it's in a rage. Sometimes it sings, sometimes it sighs. We feed it the best food that money buys, but it's not happy, it's not free. And it touched my heart indelibly to see it locked inside a cage. It made me rant and it made me rage. It reminded me of how I used to be. I once wasn't happy, I once wasn't free. I had the world in all of its pelt and was in prison inside myself. Let's free it, baby. Let's let it go. Let's open up this prison door. Let's open this cage and set it free like the Lord has done for you and me. It's like we're like his parents. It's like our child, but the bird belongs into the wild. Let's free it, baby. Let's let it so. Let's be its friend and not its foe. Let's open this cage and set it free like the Lord has done for you and me. His feathers are glossy, but his body is frail. The bird reminded me of a man and said, let's free it, Betty. Let's let it fly. Let's open up his prison door. Let's be its friend and not its foe. Let's free it, Betty. Let's let it go. Let's let it fly like the Lord has done for you and I. Yeah. This is a point that I always like to close with. About the way I feel about my poetry. It's an entitled, My Poetry. My poetry is like a river running perpetually in my head, and I will keep writing forever until everything is said. My poetry is like a fire that's burning without consuming its energy. My poetry is a desire that's yearning, searching for its destiny. My poetry is more than a phrase or a thought. My poetry is more than just notions. My feelings can't be sold or bought. They come from real emotions. Can you get into my poetry? If you can get into my poetry, then you can get into me, because my poetry is the poet, and I am the poetry.
I can tell you steal the show, Pam. I'm just playing with you. He's only here 4 seconds a month. That'll hit you when you get back home. But I do wish you the best Christmas that you have ever had. And I wish you the safest Christmas. And we do want some prayer. because this is the roughest year at Mount Canaan since the 1980s. We've had a lot of people to get sick and to go home to be with the Lord. And we're not out of the woods yet. We have others who are very ill in this church. So let us pray that God's blessing and his healing will be present throughout this Christmas season, because there's other people that I call name by name who would be here tonight if it were not for sickness in their family. Amen?
Amen.
So we're going to sing a song. Let me see here. We wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you a Merry Christmas. Amen. May we all stand. Dr. Sally Cook, God bless you, sweetheart. See you home. Someone to go out upon. For we all have sinned and we all have come short of your glory and your honor. But thank you for your redeeming power. Thank you for your forgiving power. Thank you for your delivering power. Lord, we want to pray a special blessing upon the Johnson family tonight. Oh God, it's not the best hour in their lives, but you are a God that sits there and you look low. So Lord, give a special blessing. Give peace. Give your divine wisdom in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we're going to go over and fellowship with our children, anointing, to get some fruit and candy, and our not-so-children are going to get some nuts and fruits and candy. So, Lord, we ask you just to bless the fellowship. Give us traveling grace as we go back home. Tell deer to stay out of the road. Tell cars to stay in their lane. That safety might be ours. So that your love, your grace, and the edification of your Holy Spirit may rest, rule, and abide in each of our lives now, henceforth, and forevermore. Let us all sing together.